Recently, experts from space agencies all around the world faced a troubling hypothetical scenario. A mysterious asteroid has just been discovered 35 million miles away, and it was heading towards Earth. The space rock was expected to hit Earth in 6 months. The situation was fictional, part of an exercise that simulated an incoming asteroid in order to help us practice how to respond to such a situation. The simulation taught us a difficult lesson. If a near-Earth asteroid was spotted with that little warning, there's nothing we could do to keep it from hitting the planet. Experts said that no existing technologies could stop the asteroid from striking Earth within the 6-month window. There isn't a spacecraft capable of destroying an asteroid or pushing it off its path in that amount of time. In reality, if such an asteroid was heading for Earth, scientists would need years of warning. 5 years is the minimum. But scientists couldn't even find most of the dangerous space rocks that pass near our planet, which makes the chances slim that we would even get a 5 to 10 year warning. In 2005, the US Congress attempted to address this issue by mandating that NASA should track 90% of all near-Earth objects that are 140 meters or larger. An asteroid of that size could easily destroy a city the size of New York. But till date, NASA has only spotted about 40% of those objects. What this means is that we are relying on luck to keep us safe from major asteroid impacts. In NASA's recent simulation, scientists didn't know how big the hypothetical asteroid was until a week before it was set to hit Earth. They didn't know if the object was 35 meters or 500 meters across. And that makes a very big difference. A 35-meter asteroid could explode in the atmosphere and send shockwaves through a neighborhood, while a 500-meter asteroid could destroy an entire city. So a crucial part of stopping an asteroid from hitting Earth is understanding the asteroid. That includes its size, the path it takes around the sun, and what it's made of. With that information, scientists can evaluate strategies to dismantle the rock or disrupt its path. Ideally, scientists would be able to study a dangerous asteroid as it passes in its orbit around the sun. Observing a passing asteroid several times could take years or even decades. NASA has three main tools in its planetary defense. The first is to detonate an explosive device near an oncoming asteroid to break it up into smaller pieces. The second is to fire lasers that could heat up and vaporize the space rock enough to change its orbital path. The third is to send a spacecraft to slam into the asteroid, knocking it off its trajectory. NASA is about to test the last strategy. The mission is called Double Asteroid Redirection Test. It will send a probe to an asteroid in 2022 and purposefully hit it. But testing any of the three options would take years. That's why the timeline matters. The earlier astronomers can spot a dangerous space rock, the less ambitious a deflection mission would have to be. But of course, all of these methods are useless if nobody knows when the asteroid is coming. NASA is planning a mission to track down asteroids that are too dim for Earth telescopes. The NEO Surveyor mission would launch an infrared telescope into Earth's orbit in 2026. If we focus on finding those objects and tracking them, knowing their orbits, knowing where they're going to head, and then characterizing their sizes, then we should be in a really good place to defend Earth. If the telescope launch is successful, then NASA would be able to find 90% of the most dangerous near-Earth objects.